Hi and welcome to another Spine Tips video. This time we will show you how to cut your assets for animation. This is a common task and the tips shown here can help you create your characters and prepare them for rigging and animation. Here I have art for a character that I made for a personal project. I created this character in a certain pose because it was easier for me to envision his style and personality. Sometimes the pose will not be helpful for an animation rig, like the raised back hand. The first thing to identify is what kind of action your character needs to do. If he will only be standing with his hair moving, the only thing you need to rig is his hair. In this case, I know I want a fully mobile character capable of walking, running, attacking, jumping, and so on. For that, I need to separate the cape, hands, arms, shoulders, torso, scarf, hair, neck, head, skirt, boots and legs, belt, and the orb. I want each of these parts to be independent and be able to move so that I can achieve a wide range of poses. It's important to draw behind some of the overlapping parts. While these parts are hidden in the default pose, when the character moves, you don't want there to be any gaps showing. This controls the maximum range of motion, and it's why it's so important to know early on how your character needs to move. For the face, it really depends on what kind of action your character needs to do. For this example, I will cut his head and his facial features into different layers so I can paint different emotions for his eye mask and mouth, then combine them to get many different facial expressions. For smooth and natural lip movements, it's essential to focus on how you draw the joints. When drawing limbs like arms and forearms, aim to leave an area as close to a circle as possible where the joints overlap. This circular approach helps in creating seamless rotations and overlaps. If you're unsure how to end a part that overlaps another, rounding it off is usually a safe bet. This is particularly important for parts that need to rotate around their attachment points, such as knees or elbows. I want knees and elbows to retain some stiffness, so I decided to cut them into two different layers. I often rotate the limbs in Photoshop to envision how they will move in spine. Some parts can be fixed with weights and spine, but this gives a general idea of how well the joint is drawn. If you know that some parts of your assets need to bend, it's usually better to draw them straight. Here I drew his left hand straight so that can bend better in both directions. The same with the cape. I made it a fully flat rectangle as I wanted it to bend both ways. If it was drawn bent one way, bending it the other way would not deform well. I'm also separating the back of his glove. I will rig it to move the back part to fake perspective. The more pieces you separate, the more possibilities you have for movement. Avoid drawing elements on the same layer that need to appear both in front of and behind an object. His cloak goes in front of his neck and behind him, so I cut it into two layers. If the layers should connect at the middle point, draw that point on both and, once in spine, ensure that both have the same weights to tie the images together. Using weld will give you a perfect match. There is a wide variety of possible projects, and some scenarios will require creative thinking. In this case, I noticed while drawing his back arm that rotating his upper arm will cause problems at the shoulder. The shoulder is a complex joint. The rotation and deformation that happens while rotating the shoulder is hard to replicate in 2D cutout animation. It is often easiest to hide the joint entirely, so I decided to give the shoulders armor. The armor will inherit just a little bit of rotation from the upper arm. I separated it into three parts, so I have more options for movement. It is not always possible to change your design to make rigging easier, but often even small changes can save a lot of time. Before dropping my Photoshop file into Spine, I use the ignore tag for layers that I want to keep in my Photoshop file, but I don't want to see in Spine. There are many tags for customizing how your layers are imported into Spine. See the documentation link in the description. Also, I created guides so my character will be centered at his feet in Spine. You can run the Photoshop to Spine script, but just dropping the Photoshop into Spine is much faster. Our character is ready to be rigged. Next, you would add bones, constraints, and set up meshes, then start animating. For additional resources, there are a lot of live demonstrations on our Twitch stream page, together with the project files and further insights into the animation process. They're invaluable for seeing how professional animators organize and structure their assets. Have fun cutting up your characters and happy animating!